Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, Gungans and droids across our beloved empire. And why don't we give a special shout out to all of our royal sausages, aka the Royal Guard. Now I know Lord Vader's the new kid on the block and it's been talked about extensively. However, I don't want to get too far away from that Lord Vader update because with that Lord Vader update came a Royal Guard rework, and I thought we'd take some time to look into Royal Guard on a more in-depth basis. Yes, we're gonna talk a little bit about how Royal Guard works with Lord Vader. At the end of the day, the Royal Guard rework was really meant for Lord Vader, but I'm gonna show you some things in regards to free-to-play, new players, how the Royal Guard is actually quite impactful, especially since you get 7-star Royal Guards very easily as a free-to-play player. But I also, towards the end of the video, I wanna show you a very deadly, durable, possibly even a timeout team with the Royal Guard that utilizes Grand Moff Tarkin, Gary the Stormtrooper, and this will scare the living bejeebuses out of things like the Geonosians. This could be a pretty nasty team if you don't need Wat Tambor for anything else out there, especially after that great nerf of 2021. But before we talk about all that, we got to roll our sponsor, Larry Gary.
Hey! Ladies and gentlemen, Gungans and Droids, prepare your battle stations for the next big mobile game for you to dominate. Mech Arena. Now, if you're a fan of games like Overwatch or Rainbow Six Siege, you gotta check out Mech Arena, available for iOS and Android devices. And let me tell you, baby, Mech Arena is a real-time 5v5 third-person shooter combat game. Get the shields up. All right. See? Oh, ho-ho! There we go! Oh, yeah, I'm digging long arm. Oh, man. Oh, Panther long arm, just sit back. They have to, like, pretty much come all the way over here. And we're going to throw this up here. There it is. There it is. Ah, no. Come back. I see you. There we go. We got the assist. I'll take it. There we go. I think we found that meta composition right here, baby. All right. Cheap barrier up. There we go. There, one more. There it is. Easy. Come on. There we go. Oh, wait. I see you. Oh. Easy. Oh, man. There we go. That was nasty right there. And Mech Arena has just globally launched and has tons of in-game events. And there are great login rewards going on that you don't want to miss. So if you want to get started right now, hit the links down below in the video description or scan my QR code. And you will be getting 1 mil spec skin, 500 A-coins, and 70,000 credits. And get the head start before everyone else. All right, let's roll some gameplay. But actually, before we do the gameplay, I want to show you some graphics that I made that really show the impact of the Royal Sausage. So before we get too carried away, I want to first show you some graphics in regards to Royal Guard paired with Lord Vader, because yes, we can't talk about the Royal Guard without Lord Vader, because this is really the Royal Guard's main purpose. And all I'm trying to convey here is just how durable in terms of combined health and protection this unit gets, especially under the Lord Vader lead that combines both health and protection, and then the Lord Vader leadership granting 30% extra health on top of that, and then Royal Guard's new unique ability, Unyielding Defender, pulling 5% max health from Lord Vader, which Lord Vader has an absolutely monstrosity amounts of health. And Gary, I don't know, fix the teleprompter. That's probably not the right basic right there. And at the very end, with Royal Guard's new unique ability, he basically doubles his health. And on or about it, with the Relic 7 Royal Guard, you're looking at somewhere around 570,000 health with that Lord Vader lead. Now, I want to show you one more graphic here. Not everyone has Royal Guard with Lord Vader. However, a lot of people have Royal Guard, and a lot of people might want to use them with some more free-to-play accessible things like Emperor Palpatine. You are not going to still pull off those numbers like with the Lord Vader leadership, but here's an example of Emperor Palpatine, which is, I think is going to be a very common use with Royal Guard and Emperor Palpatine, which is something I'm personally using on my free-to-play account. You're getting an extra 30% health with that Palpatine lead, and not as meaningful as before. You're still missing out on about 200,000 health or so when you compare it to the Lord Vader team, but still, that is a very durable tank to rock with Royal Guard. So that is the thing I want to highlight the most before we get into this. Yes, as we're showing, it would not be a good Royal Guard rework mini review if we didn't talk about Lord Vader. So we're only going to show one Lord Vader battle, and I want to spend more of my time talking about my free-to-play account with Royal Guard. Maybe you guys have for Royal Guard, because Royal Guard is very easily accessible. Now, the developers changed what starting characters you get. You used to get Royal Guard for free at the start. Now, instead of Royal Guard, if I remember correctly, they recently changed it where you get Kylo Ren Unmastered for free.
Still, nonetheless, you're going to get Royal Guard through a crap ton of Bronzium packs out there. So one way or another, you'll get your Royal Guard to 7 stars. I never focused on Royal Guard on my free-to-play account for 2021, and I got him all the way up to 7 stars. And I finally started gearing him up a little bit until I needed stun guns and stuff, and throwing him with my Emperor Palpatine and Darth Vader team. And it's a pretty good tank, especially when you consider Gary the Stormtrooper, not really a good all-around tank. Sherry the Shortrooper is a good tank. Hard to farm and not really needed for any particular legendary out there. Royal Guard makes a lot of sense due to the ease of access for this character, and it's needed to get things like the Sith Eternal. So you're kind of knocking out a lot of birds with one stone. That's great and all, but how impactful is this, Druid? And that's the question we're really going to answer. What change of Royal Guard? Well, we could summarize it in a few different spots. Really, his basic ability gives him a higher chance to apply stun on the target for one turn. If Royal Guard has more than 50% health, which is quite often, you just stun the target for one turn, whereas before it was a pretty low chance of getting the stun to apply. So you're going to get some good control, and especially with the Imperial Phalanx. Gary, can you do a little checkup on that? Thanks, buddy. You're the best. You get Retribution, and when you get Royal Guard counterattacking, you're going to have a chance to get that stun into basic. So the thing changed with the only specialist character has is you're granting heal over times, and Empire allies are going to get health up and Retribution for two turns. And I think probably one of the more bigger things about this kit is now you can get a taunt immediately on this character, whereas before he was a purely passive character. He would only trigger his taunt when someone fell below 50% health. Now you got a bit more of an on-demand type of taunt. Not as good as a pre-taunt, but still, it's nice as you can at least get him to taunt once in a while. And especially in a Palpatine lead, lots of Terminator going, you should be able to trigger this quite a few times. And the Retribution's great for when he uses his basic on a counterattack or Darth Vader, Emperor Palpatine, Grand Admiral Thrawn. Retribution is one of the better buffs they have in this game. So that's nice. But really, the icing on the cake here is that Unyielding Defender unique ability, which now allows him to more passively heal up the team if he is not being hit. And it's good. It's better than nothing. And I kind of more consider Royal Guard to be more of a support character than I do a tank. It's a little weird, but let me explain. So he's healing up the team, which is great for recovering banners, for example. And on top of that, the thing that's really, really important is that new Zeta ability. We'll talk about whether or not that Zeta is going to be important for him. If you have Lord Vader, this is by far one of the best Zetas you could have on the Lord Vader team. The new thing with this guy is that he is going to get that 5% max health bonus equal to the leadership, the leader in the leader slot, and then he's going to double his health pool. So if you, the first part's only important for the Lord Vader lead. However, he's going to double his health pool no matter what. Lord Vader's a no-brainer, but is it worth it for things like Emperor Palpatine lead, Grand Admiral Thrawn lead, Darth Vader lead? And if you're someone that rocks those teams and you're needing a tank, I would say this is definitely a solid Zeta choice. Just being able to literally double the health pool of your character, especially when you're pulling away health from other leads and there's other leads that amplify the health. I think this is going to be a pretty solid Zeta. I don't know if it's a top tier Zeta in the game, but nonetheless, it makes him a little bit more usable. He's able to take a lot more punches. The only downside to this character that I still don't like is I wish he was a pre-taunting character. And on top of that, I feel like the 50% threshold to cross for him to taunt, it's a little too low. I kind of wish it was maybe something more like Zalbar, or maybe like how Baze, Malbus, and Troot work, where once you fall below 100%, then you taunt. However, with the Lord Vader lead, that'd be a little bit complicated because he's always at everyone's always at 100% health, and it'd be way too easy to trigger a taunt just going from 100% to 99% since it's a combined health pool. But let's talk about the other uses out of this character. You're watching some of my free-to-play footage right now on my account, and if you guys watch my streams of Grand Arena on the free-to-play account, I really haven't had a good fifth member to invest in yet because I just didn't really have the time to farm things like Sherry the Stormtrooper. Gary the Stormtrooper is not really worth investing in, but I had a 7-star Royal Guard. So after this rework, I pretty much took this guy straight up to level 85, and I brought him up a couple gear levels and threw some Omegas on him. I did not give him the Zeta just yet. It's something I am considering, but it really, you benefit more out of that Zeta the higher the gear your Royal Guard is. And right now, my Royal Guard isn't quite up there in terms of good gear level, but it's nice having ways to passively heal up my team. Very nice to get that. Keeps my low gear Imperials alive a lot longer. Getting the Retribution going so we get some nasty counterattacks. Finding a lot of fun uses out of it on the free-to-play account. So really, at the end of the day, I think Lord Vader teams are going to benefit the most, and new players coming to the game are really going to get a lot of love out of this Royal Guard. But now let's talk about more, how is he more in that mid-game, end-game range?
I think this is where you're going to kind of see the shortcomings of Royal Guard a little bit, because he's not as plug and play as Sherry the Shore Trooper. This guy used to be the ultimate plug and play character and the dawn of Star Wars Galaxies. I'm not quite feeling the plug and play as much in here, because the healing, for example, is only for Imperials. The Retribution health up, only for Imperials. And then here's where things get really interesting. I don't know how feasible this team will be, but it's using characters that really aren't being used as much in the Galactic Legends space. Thrawn got nerfed up against Galactic Legends. Grand Moff Tarkin, you got to farm him for a variety of stuff. Not really an important character. Gary the Stormtrooper, not really an important character. Really, just Wat Tambor in this line. That might be a bit hard of a sell, but it's really, I wanted to show this as a way to kind of demonstrate how powerful the Royal Guard is here. The durability of this character is great, but here he's more of a support role rather than being a tank like Gary the Stormtrooper is. Get Wat Tambor, throw over that Taunt Tech, over the Gary the Stormtrooper, and all the attention is going to be focused on Gary, who has incredibly high protection and very solid defense, making it very tough to kill him off, which in turn triggers Royal Guard's unique ability, Unyielding Defender. And as a result, every time Gary's being hit, Royal Guard is healing the entire Imperial team. They're recovering 6% health if some other ally except for Royal Guard took damage. So you're able to recover a ton of health. With the Thrawn lead, you're getting a lot of extra protection recovery on this team. Lots of Terminator for all the debuffs. So as you're seeing, it is very tough to get Gary to fall below and die. Royal Guard's healing the team constantly, recovering those banners, keeping you alive as long as possible. And of course, you're throwing out the Retribution, so you get some nice counterattacks, you get some nice stuns. And really, the point I was just trying to show is just how crazy this character can be with the lineup like this, which can take out Geonosians. Now, I know Geonosians aren't the new kids on the block, but they are still a very annoying team to deal with. And you aren't using things like Treya, Darth Vader, Galactic Legends, or even some other big team. You're kind of using a lot of leftover stuff here. And as you see, teams like this can be incredibly deadly for timeout type of stuff. Geonosians cannot get through this team whatsoever because of all the protection recovery through Thrawn Lee, all the health recovery through the Royal Guard, and Grand Moff Tarkin. The reason why Grand Moff Tarkin's here, he is charging up his special ability, ultimate firepower. Every time Grand Moff Tarkin's using his basic, he is stacking his potency. And then ultimate firepower allows him to remove Terminator, of course, but he's gaining offense equal to double Tarkin's potency percentage. And when you're going throughout the battle and he's constantly using his basic, he's gonna pop out some really absurd damage. And I really want to take this to a whole other level. The next battle you're about to see here is me just putting it on auto basic, not letting Tarkin use his AoE too early. And you're gonna just see how durable this team is, number one. But number two, you're gonna see that because this team is so durable, you're able to ramp up ultimate firepower to do some crazy damage. We were doing over 200, like 50,000 damage on the Geonosians, although I gotta say it's quite surprising. They could sometimes survive 250,000 damage being smashed by Grand Moff Tarkin. But anyways, as you roll this last bit of footage, the golden question is, the Royal Guard rework good? I'll say this, it's an all right rework. It's not in the level of New Gunray, Count Dooku, Jedi Knight Anakin, or heck, even the Darth Vader rework, or well, the Darth Vader rework before he got nerfed. It's an all right rework that was really just designed to be paired with Lord Vader. And it's going to be a staple character inside of that Lord Vader lineup. It's a rework that incentivized people to bring him from Relic 3, which is required for Emperor Palpatine, Sith Eternal. It incentivized people to bring him with the Relic 7, which is something I did. And some people went as far as bringing him up to Relic 8 because his relics increases health and protection, all that fun stuff, which in turn makes him even more durable with the Lord Vader lead. But even though he's not at the level of a rework like Newt Gunner, it was more just a little bit of a gimme for free-to-play people that like to pursue out the Palpatine Invader, which is a very popular farming path for people out there, and really just another great character to throw inside of that Lord Vader lineup. Nonetheless, a rework is a rework, and you guys know me, one of my most favorite things in Star Wars Galaxies are reworks, and it's great to see they threw on a little bit of new paint on this Royal Guard. They didn't go to quite the extent like some others. He didn't get the new internals or stuff like that, but just that Lord Vader ability, whoo, it's pretty huge. And I like the passive healing, but I treat him more as a support character, more than a tank per se, for the Imperials, and that allows you to do some really funny stuff like you're seeing right here. So comment down below, are you a fan of the rework? Are you using it for other things aside from Lord Vader? Would love to hear your thoughts, but as always, leave a like, comment down below, and all those beautiful thoughts. And be sure to subscribe so you're not missing a thing. And as always, Tarkin, what do we say? That's right, baby. It's great to be in the Empire today. Woo!
Whoa! Look at that damage, baby! Oh!